Good morning, children. So, children, let's start the next video of chapter number 2, and our today topic will be types of partner. Student, let's have a quick review that what we have done before in this chapter. So, children, this was chapter number 2, and the name of the chapter was Form a Business Organization. In this chapters, we are going to read about the different form of ownership which a business has to decide before starting it. In this, we have read about the first form of business organization which the owner can select, that was sole proprietorship. Student, in sole proprietorship, I have explained you that these are those type of business organization which have a single person who is handling everything. That single person only finance the business. That single person only control and take decision of the business, or in case there are any profit and losses in the business, it is a single person who is going to bear out that. That is the reason we call it sole proprietorship. Sole means alone, single, and proprietorship means ownership, where there is a single person who have the ownership of a business because he alone manage, control, finance and bear profit and losses of the business. We call that type of ownership sole proprietorship. Now, in the next one, we came to the second form of business organization, and the reason for coming to the second form of business organization was that when we go through with sole proprietorship, it was only single person who is financing day. It is only single person who is running the business. So in that case, we are using the resources of only one person in case of finance also, or in case of skills also. So which restrict the area. That is the reason we go through with a second option of ownership of form of organization, and that was joint Hindu family business. Student, in this second form of organization, joint Hindu family business, this is basically run or used in our country India only. In this, these type of business are a business of a family. It is run by a head of the family which is called Karta, and who used to take all the decision of the business, and other member of a family are the member of the business, but they have a limited liabilities. Karta has unlimited liabilities because all the decision, all the power of a business are with him only. Student, as in the first form of business organization, like that was sole proprietorship, where we are using the skill and finance of only one person, right? So in the second one, that was joint Hindu form of business, we are using the skill and finance of only one family, right? So just because of this, it make the restriction of using finance of one person in sole proprietorship and using the finance and skill of one family only in joint Hindu family business. The third form of business organization has been framed, and that was called partnership. Student, in partnership form of business organization, I have explained you that this is basically a mutual consent between two or more than two people, those who are ready to invest together and share out the profit and losses of business. That is called partnership form of business. Now, we have covered already what is partnership form, what are its features, advantage and its demerits, that is disadvantage. In this video today, we will cover about the different types of partner which we can use inside the partnership form of business organization. So student, let's come begin. We will begin our topic from here only. Types of partners. So we have many type of partners, and the first type of partner is general or active partner. Now, who can be called as a general and active partner? So an active partner is one who contribute capital, participate in the management of firm, share its profit and losses, and liable to an unlimited extent to the creditor of the firm. These partners take actual part in carrying of business of a firm on behalf of other partner also. So whenever we will describe type of partnership, we have to take certain keywords here. Like first is whether the partner take part in day-to-day activity of a business or not. Second, whether the partner contribute the capital or not. Third, whether the partner share out the profit and losses of a business or not. And last is what type of liability a partner is there. So by these four keywords only we will define it. So in general or active partner, children, these type of partners take part into the day-to-day activity of a business. First thing. Second thing, they bear out the profit and losses of the business. Third thing, they contribute investment or capital into the business. And fourth thing is that they have unlimited liabilities. It means in case they are not able to pay back the money of creditor, they have to sold their personal assets also. So all those partners who contribute capital in the business, participate in the management day-to-day activity of a firm and share its profit and losses and had unlimited liabilities for the creditor of the firm are called as a general or active partners. Now next type of partner is sleeping or dormant partner. Now sleeping partner or dormant partners are who did not take part in day-to-day activity of a business is called sleeping partner. A sleeping partner contribute capital to the firm, they share profit and losses of the business and they have unlimited liabilities. So children, all those partners who does not take part day-to-day activity of a business or a management of a firm, but they share out the profit and losses of a firm, they invest money or capital in the firm, and even they also have unlimited liabilities, these type of partners will be called sleeping partner or dormant partner. So there is only one difference here. In general or active partner, they used to take part into day-to-day activity of management of a firm. But sleeping partner does not take active part into the management or firm. Other, he invests the money, they invest the money, they share out profit and losses, and even they also have unlimited liability like general or active partner have. Now children, next is your secret partner. Now, a secret partner is one whose association with the firm is unknown to the general public. In other aspect, it is like rest of the partner only. He contribute to the capital of the firm, take part in the management, share its profit and losses, and even has unlimited liabilities toward the creditor. It means children, secret partners are those partners who are unknown to the general public. Their identification from the firm is not shown to the general public. General public does not know about these type of partners, but these partners contribute to the day-to-day activity of a business. They share profit and losses also, they invest their money also, and even they also have unlimited liabilities. So these type of partners are called as secret partner. Now next is nominal partner. Now what is nominal partner? A nominal partner is one who allow the use of his or her name by a firm but does not contribute to its capital. He she does not take active part in the managing the firm, does not share its profit and losses, but is liable like other partner to the third party for the repayment of firm debts. So nominal partner basically means a partner who is allowing the use of his or her name by a firm. Means a partner is there who is allowing a firm to use his name to that particular firm, but that partner does not contribute the capital, they does not take active part in the management, they does not share profit and losses of the management, but because they allowed other firm to use their name, so they are liable for the repayment of firm debts. So all those partner only give his name and goodwill to the firm. He neither invest money nor take profit, but his liability is unlimited. Now next is partner by stipulation. Now children, a person is considered a partner by Staple if through his or her own initiative, conduct or behavior, he she give an impression to other that he or she is the partner of that firm. Such partners are held liable for the debt of the firm because in the eye of the third party, they are considered partners. Even though they do not contribute capital or take part in its management, but they will be liable for the debt of the firm. Now children, partner by Staple basically say that if he is one who by his own word or by his own conduct or by he has given certain impression to the other or outside world that he is a partner of the firm, whereas actually he is not. His liability is unlimited toward the third party who has entered into dealing with firm on the basis of his presentation. It basically means partner by Staple basically means all those person who show to other by their initiative, by their conduct, by their impression or by their behavior that they are the partner of some particular organization or a particular firm, but actually they are not the partner. They dealt with certain deal with outside people, and in that deal, if anything loss occurred, they will be having unlimited liabilities for those. So partner by Staple basically means a person is not partner, but he or she is showing to other that they are the partner of the firm, or just because of this initiative, if they have conducted any deal with the third party, they will be having unlimited liabilities regarding that deal. So that type of partner is called partner by Staple. Now children, I'll just give you example here also. Like suppose there is Rani is there, she is a friend of Seema who is partner in a software firm, right? Now on Seema request, Rani accompanies her to business meeting with Mohan Software and actively participate in the negotiation process for a business deal and give the impression that she is also the partner of the firm. If credit is extended to Simplex Solution on the basis of these negotiation, Rani would also be liable for the repayment of such debt as if she is a partner of the firm. So it basically says that two friends are there, Seema and Rani, where Seema is a partner of Simplex firm. Rani is her friend. Seema has requested Rani to join a meeting with her also, and she has joined meeting where Rani has shown an impression to the third party that she is a partner of the business, which she is not. And during this time only, they have a deal with third party. If there is any debt arise with the third party, because Rani has also given an impression to the third party that she is the partner, in that case, she also have unlimited liabilities toward the firm. So that type of partner is known as partner by Staple. Now next type of partner is partner by holding out. Now children, partner by holding out said you that a partner by holding out is a person who is not a partner in a firm, but knowingly allow himself herself to be represented as a partner in a firm. Such a person become liable to outside creditor for repayment of any debt which have been extended to the firm on the basis of such representation. In case he is not really a partner and want to save himself from such a liability, he should immediately issue a denial clarifying his position that he is not a partner in the firm. If he does not do so, he will be responsible to the third party for any such debt. It means partner by Staple and partner by holding out are near about same. Only the difference is there. In case of partner by holding out, a person holding out partner is a person who though is not a partner in a firm but knowingly allow himself or herself. It means when a person who is not a partner of the organization but he is showing that he is a partner of organization to the third party willingly, knowingly, right? In case of partner by tuple, it was not knowingly, it was not willingly, right? So when a third person or a person who is not a partner of an organization show to the other partners and to the third party willingly that he is a partner of the organization and engage in certain deal, and in case there is anything wrong occurred regarding that deal, he will be also having unlimited liability toward the party who has dealt with the firm on the basis of his declaration. So partner by holding out basically means a partner, one who is falsely declared partner of the firm. He is not a partner, but he is declaring it wrongly, whereas actually he is not a partner. Even after becoming aware of it, he does not deny it. So in case his liability is unlimited toward the party who has dealt with the firm on the basis of their declaration. So with this, children, these are the six different way or different form of different type of partners which we used inside the partnership form of business organization. Now, one marks question sometime came that what is minor and can minor as a partner of a business or not. So just go through with this. A minor is a person who has not attained the age of 18 years. So who is a minor? Any person who has not come to the age of 18 years, who has not attended the age of 18 years will be known as minor. It means below 18 year person will be known as minor. Since a minor is not capable of enlarging into a valid agreement, he cannot become a partner of a firm. So you have to clear here that when we talk about partnership business, a minor cannot become a partner of a firm because he cannot be capable of enlarging into a valid agreement. Now, however, a minor can be admitted to the benefit of an existing partnership firm with the mutual consent of all other partners. He cannot be asked to bear the losses. His liability will be limited to the extent of capital contributed by him. He will not be eligible to take an active part in the management of a firm. So, if there is any existing business or existing firm or existing partnership firm in with the mutual consent of other partners, with the willingness of other partners, it can be done that a minor can also be called for a partner, but with this legal thing that he will not bear out any losses of a business. He can contribute capital, but according to the limit of the capital, he will have to, liability has to be limited. It means his liability will be not be unlimited, his liability will be limited according to the extent of capital. He will not be eligible to make any active part in the management of a firm. It means that person who is minor will not take part in the management of a firm, or he will not take part regarding any decision of a firm. Now next, children, types of partnership. Now in the types of partnership, we have basically divided partnership types into two manners. The first is we classified partnership on the basis of duration, means timing, and second is we classified partnership on the basis of liabilities. Now when we classified partnership on the basis of duration, we got two things there. First is partnership at will, and second is partnership or particular partnership. Now what is partnership at will? Now partnership at will basically say that these type of partner exist at the will of the partner. It can continue as long as the partner want, and it can be terminated whenever any partner give a notice to withdrawal from partnership to the firm. It means partnership at will type of partnership completely depend on the will of a partners. Whenever a partner want to exit, easily the partnership can be exited. Now next is particular partnership. Now particular partnership is the second part of duration, and this said that partnership formed for the accomplishment of a particular project, say construction of a building or an activity to be carried out. Once that particular period is over, that partnership will also dissolve. So this say this type of partnership is formed for a specific period only, or to complete a particular project only. Once that specific period is over
and that particular project is over, that partnership will automatically dissolve. So this is the first form of partnership which came inside classification on basis of duration. Now next is classification on the basis of liability. Now on the basis of liability, partnership are divided into two part. The first is general partnership and the second is limited partnership. Now what is general partnership? Now children, general partnership basically say that in general partnership, the liability of a partner is unlimited and joint. The partners enjoy the right to participate in the management of a firm, and their acts are binding on each other as well as on the firm. Registration of the firm is optional. The existence of the firm is affected by the death, lunacy, insolvency or retirement of the partner. It means general partnership can also be known as unlimited type of partnership, means the partnership which have unlimited type of liabilities. These type of partnership are partner have the liability unlimited and unlimited liability, and these liabilities are joined by all of the partners together. Now children, the second form of partnership is your limited partnership. Now limited partnership is the liability of at least one partner is unlimited, whereas the other partner may have limited liabilities. Now limited partnership basically say that in this type of partnership, the liability of other partner, at least only one person partner, should be unlimited, but rest of the partner can enjoy the liability of limited here. Such a partnership does not get terminated with the death, lunacy or insolvency of limited partnership. It means if there is anything wrong occurred, the death, lunacy, insolvency with any limited partner who have the limited liability, these type of partnership will not be terminated. Which in general partnership case, if there is any partner who is injured, who is dead, the partnership has to be dissolved. Now the limited partner do not enjoy the right of management, and their act do not bind the firm or the other partners. Registration of such partnership is compulsory, where in case of general partnership, the registration of partnership was not compulsory, but in case of your limited partnership, registration of firm is compulsory. So these are basically the types, classification of types of partnership. Student, I'm again revising this type of partnership. We have divided into two type of partnership. The first was on the basis of duration, means on the basis of time, and second was on the basis of liability. On the basis of duration, we have read partnership at will. Partnership at will basically say that all those type of partnership which will exist till the will of partner is there. When partner want to leave or dissolve the partnership, they can terminate the partnership. That is the reason we called it partnership at will. Particular partnership basically means a partnership which is formed due to certain reason, due to certain project or due to certain time. That particular time, when that time will get over, the particular purpose will over, the partnership will automatically dissolve. Next was classification on the basis of liabilities. There are two things, general partnership and limited partnership. General partnership basically means the liability of partner is unlimited and joint here. Registration is not compulsory here. But in case of limited partnership, there should be only one person, at least one person who have unlimited liability, where rest will have limited liabilities, and registration is compulsory here. So this is all about partnership today. In the next video, children, we will learn about the partnership deed. Thank you.